Summer, winter, whatever the season it is, Pakodas has its own place, a best companion along with our cup of tea. A very crispy Pakodas goes very well with your evening cup of tea or any time as a snack. Hello everyone, welcome to Latu's Kitchen. After watching this video, do not forget to subscribe and do leave a like if you like the video and do share it with your friends. It means a lot. Yes, so let's straight away get into the video, how to make crispy spinach pakodas. Few tips I would be sharing how to get a crispy pakodas. With a sound you can make out how crisp it is. Yes. It just melts on your mouth. Do give it a try. Let's get started. These are the ingredients. 2 cup of besan, which is gram flour. 3 tablespoons of rice flour, which will give more crisp to the pakodas. And the spice powder. 1/2 a tablespoon of turmeric powder, 1 tablespoon of chili powder, some salt, green chilies and grated ginger, hing, chopped onions, preferable straight cut, not finely, crushed coriander seeds, 2 cups of spinach, finely chopped, of course washed before and finely chopped them. Sprinkle the water, don't pour the water, just sprinkle it and squeeze the spinach leaves and the onions. The onions has got its own juice, so you need to give it a mix just with the juice of onions and the spinach just by sprinkling a little water, not by pouring too much water. Yeah, so likewise squeeze everything gently but not firmly. Mix all well together, let all the spices blend well with the flour and the vegetables. Yes, this is the right consistency we needed to make our crispy pakodas. It shouldn't be too watery. That's why I've asked you to sprinkle water. In the meanwhile, take your kadai, add oil. I'm using sunflower oil. Take the batter and spread it over by using your fingers little by little, but not dump it too much. It needs to have its place for it to fry. Don't dump it too much with the batter, just little by little. Yes, you require a lot of patience to cook this by little, but that's how you cook it. It needs some space for it to get cooked so that it will be more crispy. Now try to turn it gently. It needs to cook both sides. Yes, one by one like this. Keep working on it by turning here and there. You need to cook this till the sizzling sound stops. Once that sound stops, which means it is done nice and crisp. Now you can see the onions have turned golden, the pakodas is in a right consistency. You can hear the sound. Once it is completely cooled down, it will be even more crispier. Now transfer that into a separate plate. Likewise, make the remaining pakodas. Cook till the sizzling sound stops and take it out. A very simple, easy method of making crispy pakodas. Today I'm using spinach. So spinach pakoras are very healthy pakoras. A best way to make your kids eat spinach, if they are reluctant to eat green leafy vegetables, then this is the best way. And even otherwise, a very healthy snack while it is deep fried, but yes, due to vegetables, you can as well use, rather than rice flour, use millet flour, tinai varagu, that is proso millet or a foxtail millet, any millet, you can make it into a fine powder and you can use it instead rice flour. It will be even more crispier and health wise also it is very good. Once it is cooked, take it out, allow it to cool down completely, then store it in a airtight container. It remains very fresh for at least 3 to 4 days. A best snack, guys, along with your tea. So I'm sure you're gonna give it a try. Let me know how you liked it. Looking forward to see your comments on the comment section. If you're new here, please do subscribe after watching. Thank you so much for tuning into Latu's Kitchen. Please do share it with your friends if you can. Thank you so much.